After our successful coverage of the 68th General Assembly, this year, once again, the permanent mission of Equatorial Guinea opened its door to ACRTV on the occasion of the celebration of their 45th anniversary of independence. Ambassador Anatolio Ba and his staff greeted the guests with the customary hospitality of Equatorial Guinea. 45 years ago, this country became independent from Spain. After a period of economic uncertainty, today, under the leadership of President Obiang Nguema Mbasogo, Equatorial Guinea is in the ascending march toward development. All things being equal, this country will soon be counted among the emerging economies. Through an exclusive interview, the permanent representative of the Republic of Equatorial Guinea, Ambassador Anatolio Ba, took us through this journey.
This occasion is marked in our country with a lot of celebration, but not only just celebration, but also inauguration. Every year we have anniversary. Our head of state, the head of the government, inaugurate a lot of projects regarding infrastructures, let's say roads, schools, hospitals. Except the first 11 years of our independence, but from 79, during in which His Excellency Obiang Nguema Mbasogo took the power, 3 August 79, until today, the country celebrating peace and development.
Using the natural resources of the country to enhance the welfare of his fellow countrymen during the last two decades, President Obiang Nguema Mbasogo has managed to implement good governance that translated in a profound transformation of the living condition in Equatorial Guinea. Today, Equatorial Guinea is deeply entrenched in the path of a sustainable development.
The analphabetism was really very high, and the mortality rates were very, very high. There were no schools, electricity, roads to make a road to go to a distance of, I would say, 50 kilometers in a car. You will make it, let's say, about 5, 6, 7 hours.
Oh my God.
You see? So from then to today, all have changed. The configuration of the country is totally changed.
Talking about the birthday of your beloved country, Mr. Ambassador, tell us about one of the heroes in your country.
In the independence, we had heroes who fought for the independence in the colonial times. We have, they are already dead, they gave their life for the cause of independence. We have Enrique Mvo, we have Acacio Meunier, our current hero, because he took the country from nothing to where we are today, is Obiang Nguema Mbasogo.
The vision of President Nguema is well appreciated in the continent and far beyond. The ambassador of the African Union to the United Nations was not shy to praise his leadership, such leadership that can inspire the continent to achieve its potential.
La Guinée équatoriale, c'est l'Afrique, c'est le symbole même de l'Afrique qui avance. Souvent, quand on parle de l'Afrique, on aime montrer le message négatif. Et souvent, on n'amène pas nécessairement ce qui avance en Afrique. Voilà un pays qui a connu la Guinée équatoriale et qui la connaît maintenant, qui réellement travaille et honore beaucoup notre continent, non seulement par ce qu'il fait à l'intérieur du pays, je parle du gouvernement guinéen, le président Obiang, non seulement ce qu'ils font pour leur pays, mais ce qu'ils font pour le continent aussi. C'est un pays qui investit aussi sur le continent, qui croit au continent et qui a un discours, en fait, un discours progressiste. Ce qui est important, c'est un discours progressiste qui croit en l'avenir de l'Afrique et qui met le peu de moyens qu'ils ont aussi pour que l'Afrique avance ensemble, en fait.
In the same vein, the permanent representative of Botswana was equally appreciative of the tangible economic growth of Equatorial Guinea.
This is a country that has done so much in terms of economic growth and improvement of the living conditions of their people. And we all know that Equatorial Guinea is mineral rich. They are one country in Africa which has registered very impressive rates of economic growth persistently. And I'm very proud to be here tonight to be celebrating their anniversary of independence.
The ambassador of Senegal was present and evoked the long-standing of an harmonious, respectful, and peaceful cooperation between the two countries. He also gave a vote of confidence to the leadership of President Obiang Nguema Obasanjo.
Monsieur l'ambassadeur du Sénégal, vous voulez dire un peu le mot de la Guinée équatoriale aujourd'hui à l'occasion de leur anniversaire d'indépendance?
Mais tout à fait, c'est avec beaucoup de plaisir que je le ferai, ce d'autant que l'ambassadeur, le représentant permanent de la Guinée équatoriale aux Nations Unies est un ami et surtout un aîné, parce qu'il a été également fonctionnaire international basé à Dakar pendant longtemps. Il parle les langues sénégalaises, donc c'est avec beaucoup de joie que je viens honorer son pays qui fête donc le 35e anniversaire de son indépendance. La Guinée équatoriale est un pays important sur l'échiquier africain. On se rappelle que le président Théodore Obasanjo l'a dirigé l'Union africaine et que son bilan a été très positif. Son engagement pour l'unité africaine, pour le développement de l'Afrique, a été constant. Il a représenté notre continent à plusieurs rencontres internationales. Donc il était important pour nous de saluer la Guinée équatoriale et surtout également le développement prodigieux qui s'est enclenché en Guinée équatoriale au profit des populations équato-guinéennes et surtout au profit des populations de l'Afrique centrale. Donc il était important que ce pays qui est devenu aujourd'hui un modèle pour l'Afrique soit honoré ici aux Nations Unies et c'est la raison pour laquelle vous le voyez si bien. Tous les représentants permanents africains à New York sont présents. Et bien entendu, ils sont accompagnés par des représentants permanents d'autres pays européens, américains et asiatiques. Donc c'est avec beaucoup de joie que nous sommes là pour fêter la Guinée équatoriale.
What are the natural resources of Equatorial Guinea?
Equatorial Guinea is a country potentially a lot of resources. You have a lot of the rainforest, a lot of timber. You have fertile soil because the island is volcanic. We are little in extension, in the earth extension, but very big in the marine extension. So you have potentially fisheries. Aliotic resources. Currently we have oil. We are the third producer country in sub-Saharan Africa. And we have also gas. We convert this oil also into gas. But other potential resource, because of the beauty of the country, the beautiful beach and the mountain and the forest, potentially have also looking forward to develop the tourism. That will become an important economic resource also.
The ambassador of Gabon, a neighboring country, emphasized on the brotherhood of the two countries.
Vous savez que c'est toujours un plaisir de venir célébrer avec nos frères de la Guinée équatoriale. Le Gabon et la Guinée équatoriale sont deux pays pas amis, mais deux pays frères, parce que nous sommes liés par la géographie, mais aussi par d'autres choses. Et donc c'est toujours un plaisir de venir ici partager ces moments de commémoration avec nos frères de Guinée équatoriale.
C'est des relations fraternelles et cordiales. Nous sommes liés, disons, par la culture. Nous sommes liés aussi par nos populations. Vous trouvez des Fang en Guinée équatoriale et des Fang au Congo, au Cameroun et au Gabon. Donc ce sont les mêmes populations qui sont là, que la géographie a peut-être éloigné, mais nous avons la CEMAC et la CAC qui nous unissent.
L'Équatorial Guinée est un pays important en Afrique. Botswana est dans la partie sud de l'Afrique et nous sommes très eager de renforcer nos relations avec nos frères et sœurs dans d'autres parties de l'Afrique. Et l'Équatorial Guinée est un de ces pays.
The ambassador of Gambia added his voice in the cohort of praises to salute the success of Equatorial Guinea and its positive role in the region.
Well, I feel honored and happy to be here. I remember this year in February, the president of Equatorial Guinea graced the celebration of our independence in the Gambia. So I think as the permanent representative of the Gambia, it's my duty and obligation to come and show solidarity with our brothers from Equatorial Guinea. And beside the ambassador is our elder brother, and he's been very helpful and supportive. So I think we are all honored to be here to wish them a happy anniversary and wish them all the best.
Two female citizens of Botswana willfully expressed their happiness to be a part of this independence anniversary celebration.
It's a pleasure for me to be here celebrating with my dear brethren and sisters from Equatorial Guinea. I'm not political myself, but I'm glad that Equatorial Guinea hosted the Africa Cup of Nations in 2010. Is it 2012? In 2012. And that time my national team Zebras happened to be participating in the celebrations. So I'm very proud to be part of this celebration.
It's been a really lovely evening. I'm very proud to be here with another African country and witnessing another independence from them, and it's been a lovely evening.
An African American who is an honorary citizen of Equatorial Guinea, shared his thought with us as well.
For African Americans with citizenship in Equatorial Guinea, celebrating the anniversary for the second year, it's just a humbling feeling that the president has just told the diaspora to come home. So with the Holy Father and the president, this is just a beautiful day. I'm just overwhelmed with so much joy and really a gratefulness for President Obeng of just leading the country to records, leaps and bounds. I'm just grateful to be welcome home.
The food was excellent. All the fin gourmets got their fair share. The event regained in momentum with the arrival of the ambassador of Equatorial Guinea in Washington, D.C., accompanied by his wife. We all felt like a big family that was consciously enjoying a great moment.
Today, we are celebrating 45 years of the independence of Equatorial Guinea. Like all my countrymen, we are very happy because 45 years ago, the dream of the father of our independence, Enrique Mboa, Cassio Manye, and other national leaders who fought for the independence, was realized. And it has not been easy, but today we can see that our country has achieved a lot of development, not only in the socio-economic aspect, but in health, education, infrastructure. The President of the Republic, His Excellency Obiang Nguema Mbasogo, is committed to continue with this program of the development of our country. If you go look at Equatorial Guinea today is very different from the Equatorial Guinea people know in the past decades. Today, the country has a direction of development. This is one thing. The other thing is, we are here today to encourage the ambassadors, our ambassador and permanent representative to the United Nations with his staff, so that they can continue representing effectively our country to the United Nations. And Equatorial Guinea, as a member state of the United Nations, will continue to support the UN as a state member In regard with our relation with the United States, we are also strengthening our bilateral relation. As you know, Equatorial Guinea and the United States, we both share the diplomatic representation. There's an ambassador in Washington who is me, and now we also have a U.S. ambassador in Malawi. So we are very happy here today to celebrate this 45th anniversary, and we want and we pray for God to bless our country for the years to come, forever and ever. Thank you.
Where do you see Equatorial Guinea 5 years from now?
Implementing, executing a national plan called Horizon 2020, which is to make the country become an emergency country in 2020. So I will say, not in 5 years' time, I will say in seven years' time, I will see a country where with a remarkable social development, economic development, political development, and cultural development.
Participants at the event were thankful to the permanent mission of Equatorial Guinea to the United Nations for hosting such a great gathering. They were all saying their ways, Adelante, Equatorial Guinea.